25 years of age now, the Pan Pacific champion, striking double gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes now.
This is the final of the women's 1500 freestyle. Katie Ledecky in for the United States and the favourite. There are two Americans in this final, because the 20-year-old Erica Sullivan will be next to Ledecky. And in the golden lanes will be Wang Zhangjie from China. Bronze at the World Championships, what can she do at the Olympic level? Well, this is the way they line up then for Australia in lane 8. Kia Melverton, silver in the Pan Pacific. She's a world champion in the 4x2 relay, coming here into the 1500. The first time this event has been swum for women at the Olympic Games.
Her training partner Maddie Goff is in the cross in lane number 1. They both train with Chris Nesbitt on the Gold Coast at the TSS Aquatic Club.
And 7 from Germany, the veteran Sarah Kohler, 27 years of age. World record holder short course in her time. She's a world silver medalist, also swims open water, coming here in the 1500.
Anastasia
Kipichnikova.
Thank you. Thank you for that. World ranked in 2016.
In 6 for Italy, Simona Quadrella, the world champion, double European champion, fourth fastest in this event of all time. The Italian in 6.
I've got this one. Erica Sullivan in lane number 3 from Las Vegas, Nevada. Her mum is Japanese. She feels a close connection to racing here in Japan.
In 4, the 19-year-old from China, Wang Zhang Xiaha, world bronze medalist, Asian Games champion. A medal on offer for her.
And can she finally break through to a gold medal performance? Katie Ledecky in the 1500 freestyle, second in the 400, fifth in the 200. She's raced the 200 also today.
Katie Ledecky is one of the greatest female swimmers of all time. She's been beaten in the 400 in the second. She's been beaten, roundly beaten in the 200. Didn't win a medal in that event, but I feel as though she had half her mind on this 1500 metres final. History in the making, because this is the first time the 1500 has been swum at the Olympic level. The athletes are called to the blocks. Ledecky is the world record holder, and let's see what she can provide in this final of the women's 1500. We expect Ledecky to go out and then break the field fairly early, but the 19-year-old Wang of China may have something to say about that. Quadrella will hang on to her as long as she can. The Italian in 6 with all the experience in the European and world level. She's only 22 years of age, so age is on the side of the Italian. Ledecky already beginning to impose herself. I don't think she's going to shake off the others as easily as she might have done in the past at this Olympic final, but we do expect her to... Well, she is the favourite. We expect her to win, but who knows?
Well, quite focused at the moment. Just getting into a nice rhythm in the first 100 metres. She only breathes off to the right-hand side. In answering the question for her Olympic biography, lane 5, Wang was asked who her hero was, and it's Ledecky. And now she finds herself in an Olympic final right beside her idol. First 100 metres is swum, and Ledecky goes around in 59.12. So a sub 1 minute for the first 100 metres.
Well, Ledecky is in her office here, this 1500 freestyle. She has the top 10 times of all time, from 15.20 down to 15.35. Nobody else in the field has come close to that. Wang's best time, 15.41. Quadrella's best time, 15.40. And so on down. And that's why Ledecky is such a favourite in this event, and all of her year will have been focused, or a few years will have been focused on the distance events, because she can do the 800 and the 1500 at the Olympic level now. So almost a gift of a medal. If you're the dominant swimmer in the 800, you come up to the 1500 and you say thank you.
Here's the 200 meter split. She's got herself into a nice rhythm already. She's going at 31 seconds on this lap, the odd numbered laps, and a 30 seconds on the even numbered laps. It's Wang just sitting in, tucked into that lane rope, that golden lane rope that you can see. Ledecky just floating with the legs, nicely balanced. Brings them in a little bit more just as she turns. Good discipline underwater as well. Does one fly kick, then up to the free.
Well, look at the clock. Her world record came off 302.50. It's not about records. It's not about times at Olympic Games. It's about the medals. World records, best times, national records can all come at any meet anywhere in the world, but you only get one chance to win an Olympic medal. And look at the distance Ledecky is in front of the field at the 300-meter mark. The race behind her is closer to us in lanes 5, 6 and 7. That's Wang just in the lead of those three at the minute. Quadrella, the Italian, in 6. And Sarah Kohler from Germany. Plenty of experience in the body of Sarah Kohler, and she'll want to have a say in where the medals go here. It's going to be a tough ask, and all these athletes are going to have to measure their effort in these early stages.
Well, swimmers have different tactics as to how they break it up. Coaches will give you the instructions whether or not they're breaking it up as 3 500 meters. For the 1500 freestyle, that's certainly the way that most swimmers will attack it. You could split it as the 2 750 meters as well. 1500 freestyle now added to the Olympic roster, as to the 800 freestyle for men's.
Nice race developing behind Ledecky. We're enjoying watching somebody so dominant in this sport performing. So we'll enjoy Ledecky. This should be a procession to the gold. You never know. You just never know. If Ledecky starts to tie up, if some of the fatigue comes in, the week starts to catch up with her, you give an opportunity to someone like the 19-year-old Wang, who is on the rise, and who knows what happens. And especially with the three behind her, they're going to be pushing each other because they know that already they've broken the rest of the field. So the medals will come probably from these four. Further down in lane 2 and 3, there's a good battle between Kopichnikova and Erica Sullivan, the second Americanness.
The last two 50-meter laps, Wang has actually taken some time off Ledecky. So she's taken about 0.8 of a second off Ledecky over the last 100 meters. Just watching, Ledecky is circling a little more as well. It's a sign of just letting the mind wander a little bit. You want to stay straight down. See, she pushed straight off into the other side lane rope. Do want to try and stay center of the pool.
And they're catching her.
Well, she doesn't look as high in the water, Ledecky, at the moment. She's still repeating at about 31 seconds for the 50 meters freestyle. 31.3 was the last 50. But so too are the other girls.
Well, this will ebb and flow a little bit. You can see the velocity of the swimmers, and you can see the 50-meter splits that will keep you up to date with as the race goes on. But Ledecky is not shaking off the attentions of the three, but her tactic is just to get a comfortable lead early on and then stay there. Ledecky won't mind if the lead doesn't increase. She will start to mind if she senses the rest of the field coming towards her as the race goes on, especially if you get to the 1100, 1200 meter mark and they're on your feet. And it's always with the momentum and enthusiasm, the energy with the chaser rather than the leader. And Ledecky will want to avoid that. She knows exactly what she's doing. As the three swimmers
Ledecky's best 400 freestyle time is that 3:56. The girls that are sitting in behind her, their best times are around the 4:03 mark.
Good skills around the turn from the American, and she's certainly not sticking to the walls, and sometimes the distance swimmers, they don't practice those skills often enough and lazy around the turns, and you can lose a tenth, 2/10 to a rival, and they all add up on the distance event.
Well, Ledecky seems to be increasing the lead now. We'll have a look as she turns at the 700 metre mark of the 1500 freestyle. Interesting, off the even end, she's not doing any fly kicks off the wall. She just comes up with a couple of little freestyle kicks. But at the 50 metre end, the odd turn end, she actually does a couple of butterfly kicks.
So nicely balanced for Ledecky. You can see that left foot just bouncing away as she takes breathing to the right. Behind her, the race hotting up now between the three. Someone's not going to win a medal out of those three unless they dead heat. We've got Wang in five, remember. Quadarella, the Italian, in six. And Sarah Kohler from Germany in seven. That battle is certainly one to watch. Katie Ledecky, the procession at the lead of this race as we come through. No doubt about who's leading. Quadarella just beginning to up the tempo a little bit. She's trying desperately to shake off the attention of her rivals. They're not going to let her go. 800 metres then. Katie Ledecky, she's gone past halfway. It's downhill all the way to the finish now for the leader. Quadarella in second place. Wang just about in third, but not much in it. A turn of speed from someone like Wang or Sarah Kohler, and everything could change.
She's gone a 4:08 high for that 400 metres, so 4:06 high, actually 4:09 low. So pretty nicely split at the 800 metre mark.
And you can see a clear difference in the strokes between Quadarella. Much higher turnover of strokes. She's taking more strokes per length compared with Wang. A more traditional, longer stroking distance freestyle shape to the stroke. And you would think that that would conserve a bit of energy for Wang. It's not always the case because changing gears in a distance event is difficult. Ledecky still in the lead, dominating this 1500-metre final in her preferred events. Could be the first gold for Katie Ledecky.
Underwater with Ledecky, and you just see that really good balance with the legs. She's almost dragging the legs. It's almost like she's doing a pool boy set at the moment. She hasn't got them working at all. As opposed to Wang, you can just see little bursts of a six-beat kick there. Quadarella also with just that two-beat distance freestyle kick. Nice work off the walls from Kohler. Feel like she's starting to try and make a move. She just went 0.3 of a second quicker than the girls beside her. So Sarah Kohler from Germany is trying to make a move coming into this 1,000-metre mark.
As we get to the 1,000 metres, Katie Ledecky in front by some distance. She's got 500 to go at this point. And Kohler beginning to make a break. And this is where you have to break the field. This is where it starts getting really tough in the 1,500. The next 200 metres could be decisive. If Kohler can shake off the attentions of Quadarella and Wang, then she's going to be in a fine position for a medal. They won't let her go, though. Quadarella has been in an enormous number of fights over the years in these distance events. We haven't seen the same for Wang in international competition. And Wang is eye to eye, stroke for stroke with the Italian as Kohler of Germany tries to make a break. She's just extending a tiny bit of a lead in front of Wang, but Wang is responding now to the German. Quadarella is the one looking vulnerable, the Italian from lane six.
Well, the other one that's got a little bit of momentum, as we see, Katie Ledecky, her second 500 metres was 5 minutes 14 seconds, so 5:09, 5:14, is Erica Sullivan over in lane number three. She was a fair way behind, and she's just been chipping away for the last 300 or 400 metres to try and bridge this gap, and she's not far away now. So she's bringing in some 6 feet kicking off the walls. So the other American, the second American, the 20-year-old Erica Sullivan, looking to try to break the girls on the other side and break into the medals.
Quadarella struggling. Momentum with Sullivan up in three. Eating away into the gap in front of her and the medals. Erica Sullivan has some momentum. Fresher. Feeling as though she's chasing people down. That's always a good position to be. Quadarella looks as though this is over for the Italian because Sarah Kohler has managed to make the break. Wang in close attention. Erica Sullivan in close attention. That's where the battle looks like it's going to be. 1,200 metres now, 300 to go for Katie Ledecky. Still in front by some distance. On her own now in second, Sarah Kohler. What a result this would be for the German. Now a tie for third between Wang and Erica Sullivan.
Can't help but feel that the momentum for the second and third place in this race of the silver and bronze medals has swung towards Erica Sullivan for at least bronze. Can she keep working her way up to Sarah Kohler, who has pulled away from the other girls beside her? But it's no doubt that Ledecky is on her way to win her first Olympic Games gold medal of 2020 here in Tokyo.
To add to the five she's already won in her career, it's a huge collection of hardware for Ledecky. 15 golds in the World Championships, if you can believe it. Now, the three contesting for the two medals behind Ledecky as she turns with 200 metres to go. O'Sullivan on the charge, and it looks as though O'Sullivan might just move up into second place now. This is going to be a grandstand finish between Erica Sullivan in lane three, the American, and in lane seven, Sarah Kohler. 20 years of age, Erica Sullivan. What a result this would be, and it's all about taking the opportunities when they present themselves to you, and you have to be ready. It's all about preparation and opportunity.
Well, the last 200 metres, Erica Sullivan has been dropping in 31 low. I reckon this 50, she's still sitting at around that 31 low as well. But 31-0 compared to Kohler, who's at 31-6. So half a second every lap, she's taking off Kohler.
And Sullivan with a slightly higher turnover of stroke. The intent in the form of Sullivan is clear. She's come up through the ranks, sat back at around 400. She knew what she was capable of doing. The bell goes 100 metres for Katie Ledecky. And if she's not careful, Sullivan might run her down, I doubt it. But Katie Ledecky in the lead. The lead is not as great as it was a few hundred metres ago.
And for the first time since the first 100 metres in this 1500, we see a little more action from Katie Ledecky with her legs, bringing in a kick with just 50 metres to go to a historic first victory in the 1500 freestyle for women. She will forever write her names in the history books. She'd already done that in 2016, but now she will become the first name in the records of the 1500 freestyle Olympic history.
The legs come in for Katie Ledecky, bringing this 1,500 metres home for the United States. And in her wake, Erica Sullivan working desperately hard for the silver medal. Sarah Kohler battling closer to us, but it looks as though it's going to go to the American. This could be an American 1-2. History for Katie Ledecky. Victory in 15:37. And on the charge, a wonderful performance for the 20-year-old Erica Sullivan in front of Sarah Kohler. And look at the Americans celebrating. 1-2 for the United States. Magnificent swimming in the first ever Olympic women's 1500 metre freestyle.
And Sarah Kohler, she is absolutely ecstatic. Arms in the air. She wins an Olympic medal in the 1500 freestyle for Germany. What a great swim by Erica Sullivan. She really just paced it so well. And Katie Ledecky is in tears at that victory.
Well, She's put her goggles back on. She doesn't want those images echoing around the world, but you can see how much it means to Katie Ledecky. It can't be easy being Katie Ledecky. No. The expectations are sky high. When she comes into the press conferences, they're all about, well, you've been beaten, how does that feel? And it's unfair.
She led from start to finish. There was never any doubt that she was going to claim this as her own. Just worked her way through lap after lap, very consistent. Sitting at 31 seconds after the burst of speed in the first 200 metres.
And you can see the effort on the face of Katie Ledecky. She looks across to her teammate, looks at the clock, quick fist bump.
Erica Sullivan's moved herself into number 5 of the all-time performances in the 1500 freestyle performers. She's now the 5th fastest all-time.
It doesn't break into the top 10 performances of all time. They still belong to Katie Ledecky, but in performers, what a result for Sullivan. Well, I do like to see athletes sharing the success of each other and celebrating each other's success. And the success goes to the United States. Katie Ledecky and Erica Sullivan put their names in the record books alongside Sarah Kohler, the medal winners in the first time this 1500 has been swum at the Olympic level. And that's the story.
As the pool readies itself for the victory ceremony for the women's 1500 metres freestyle. First time this takes place in Olympic history.
It'll be an emotional Katie Ledecky that will rise to the podium. The 4th gold medal of the championships in Tokyo 2020 for the US team. And it all smiles for Erica Sullivan.
Even with the mask, you can see it.
What a day for her. What a performance. America 1 and 2 with Sarah Kohler, a terrific swim in bronze. She was involved in a monster battle between Quadarella, Wang, and in the latter stages, Erica Sullivan, but Kohler broke the field to put herself in a medal position.
The medals will be presented by IOC member, United States of America.
So the medal presentation party being introduced to the stadium.
Dale Neuberger, the FINA Bureau member for the US.
He's the treasurer of FINA. He also runs the development program for FINA, to which we've seen so many swimmers from developing nations being placed in programs around the world. So some good work being done from the IOC and FINA in the development funds that have been gone to good use. As we see Sarah Kohler then, 27 years of age, from Magdeburg, arms up. This is, well, the best result of her career.
Well, her partner, Florian Welbrock, raced for Germany in the 1500 freestyle at the Rio Olympic Games. Also, she's studying law as well at Heidelberg University. Florian is here, so he'll be loving seeing his partner on the victory dais.
Silver medalist, United States of America.
She couldn't wait to get up. Great to see. Welcome to being an Olympic medalist, Erica Sullivan. Oh, she just timed it beautifully. Aitken is her coach. She's from Las Vegas. The Sandpipers of Nevada is her home club.
Sandpipers have put 2 swimmers on the American team. And it's a huge program with a long history of success. Mum's and here continuing that success.
Mum's Japanese, so that's kind of the nice connection as well.
All the experience then with Katie Ledecky. Her sixth gold medal of her career, the first of Tokyo 2020 for the third time of asking. Ledecky rises to receive the gold medal and the support and respect of the swimming community. Grew up just outside Washington, D.C. Then moved to Stanford for her collegiate career. And throughout it all, has dominated middle distance and distance swimming wherever she goes. Inspired so many people throughout her career and continues to do so as we hear the national anthem for the United States.
Well, for the first time at Tokyo, the Olympic Games here, Katie Ledecky hears the American anthem, her sixth gold medal of her career at the Olympic Games. And Erica Sullivan, her first Olympic medal. Sarah Kohler from Germany. And all of this is history-making, the first time that we've seen the 1500 freestyle at the Olympic Games for women. As the athletes now make their way around the pool for their victory lap. Ledecky's program isn't over. She has an 800 freestyle as well that she'll race. And that 800 freestyle, she'll meet Ariane Titmus, who has been dominant in the shorter of the races, the 2 and the 4.
The emotion coming out for Sarah Kohler. She can hardly believe what's happening to her this year. Going from strength to strength. 27 years of age, and this the biggest result in her career by miles. Silver at the world championship level pales into significance when you get to the Olympic level. Trying desperately to hold it together. Look, you're in tears, you've taken a mask off, and suddenly the world wants your picture. It's a little unfair, but there we are. That's the nature of it.
I'm not sure how they figure out with that press gallery and the photographer gallery, at which point do you take the mask off for the photo? And the poor photographers at either end that miss out on the photo without it. But I guess it does mark the moment in time that we are, that the world is wearing masks.
The biggest difference between Olympics and World Championships is the number of photographers you get at the Olympics. The World Championships, there are some, quite a lot, but when you stand on, walk onto the pool deck at the Olympic Games and you see the huge number of photographers on pool deck crowding around trying to get the pictures that they want, you realise and recognise what an enormous global event this is.